Welcome to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. The best wrestling action in the Southeast comes to you live, in color. Live wrestling is back, and it's bad. Southeastern Championship Wrestling, live on TV 53, WFLI.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. I'm JC, and I'll be with you for the next hour. Got a fine crowd on hand today, and I tell you what, we got some new guys that's come in here from Huntsville, Alabama. They call themselves the Midnight Riders. Glad to have you guys.
Let me tell you something. We come to the Southeastern area for one thing, for the stiff competition that we've heard of and the tag team title. Our contract for anybody, our contract is always open.
I tell you what, we ain't going to come here. You can look and you can see we're not the biggest tag team around, but what I'm going to tell you, son, is we are one of the toughest tag teams around, and when you step in that ring, you better have your boots laced because we are the quickest tag team around, and if people want to put their titles up, whether it be today, whether it be next week, we're ready. We always ready, and we will have a championship title here, Bo.
All right, glad to have you in here. The Midnight Riders. I tell you what, these guys, they come in here looking for some competition, ladies and gentlemen. When they go up against Killer Kyle or the Assassin, they go up against the Dog or Crazy, the Genius, Lou Gramm Jr. I tell you something, they may have to go back to Huntsville, Alabama. This is the way J.C. sees it, and this is the way J.C. is going to call it. And I tell you something, that's the way it is. All these guys coming in here looking for it, but once they find it, they don't want it. They're usually gone. You know what I mean? But I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, I got a special thing I need to talk about here a little later on in the match. I got a couple of people I'd like to say hello to in Cleveland, Tennessee. Jeff Stansberry getting married this coming weekend. And Mr. Joe Turner said he watches Southeastern Championship Wrestling every Saturday. Said his favorite wrestler is the Superstar. And we'll be having this one here today for you, Joe Turner and Jeff Stansberry. Congratulations to everybody. We do have some men in the ring at this time. Referee's up here checking them out and everything, and we're just going to keep everything going right along. Mr. Tony Cargo didn't show up with me today, so I don't know exactly what has happened to him. And ladies and gentlemen, in the ring at this time, Mr. Butch Brooks. And a fine athlete, his opponent today, Mr. Larry Santana. This is a 10-minute time limit. And the referee is Mr. Bobby Abbott. This is a 10-minute time limit. And this match is underway. Some of the fans out there starting some trouble there with Mr. Larry Santana. Give this man a hard time. I don't see why. He's a fine professional wrestler. Butch Brooks is a young guy trying to come up. And when he goes into the ring against someone that has the ability of Larry Santana, he's going to know that he's been into a wrestling match. Larry Santana can go fisticuff with you. Larry Santana can wrestle with you. But usually if you ever crawl in the ring with Larry Santana, you're going to find out something's a lot different. Butch Brooks pulls him in the room, slings him off there, sets him down for a big elbow smash. Larry Santana goes down. Larry Santana said if Butch Brooks pulling the tights, honestly, I didn't see it, but it's possible, I don't know. Butch Brooks can take any advantage he can to get a win over Mr. Larry Santana.
Hey, Mama ain't here. Mama come down here and pick you up.
And Larry Santana, people all the time talking about Larry Santana's mother. Larry Santana's mother is a wonderful woman. You need to meet this woman sometime. Swings Butch Brook off, big Irish whip. Here he comes. Butch Brook ducks it. Flying cross body block, got Larry Santana down. One. Larry Santana comes out and puts a boot to the back of Butch Brook. Butch Brook's holding those tights one more time. I seen him do it that time. Big hanging like that tuck Butch Brook's head off that time. Larry Santana pitched Butch Brooks up, bracing down for a big body slam. Puts a fist right in the top of Butch Brooks' head. And Butch Brooks comes out of it on the count of two. Larry Santana helping Butch Brooks up that time. Puts a forearm right across the back. Flings him off one more time, brings him up. Puts a big boot right in the chin of Butch Brooks. Butch Brooks back down on the canvas one more time. Larry Santana standing proud, picks him up, brings him back off one more time, puts him in there. Referee calls for the break. Mr. Butch may pay for pulling Larry Santana's trunks the way he did a while ago, and he did as Larry Santana brought him off the ring. Brings him over in a headlock, puts him down onto the mat. Larry Santana comes, breaks it whole, puts that boot right across the top of the head. Larry Santana holler for Butch Brooks to get up. Ooh, puts one right up the side. It was an open fist. It was open that time. Had his hand open, slaps Butch Brooks right upside the head. Open palm right there again. One's in the top of the head. One. And he comes out. Larry Santana says, no, Butch Brooks is going to have to pay for this one for pulling my tights at the beginning of the match. Brings him up one more time. Butch Brooks fires back with a fist. Look at that, a fist to the midsection. Puts a boot right in the Butch Brooks' head one more time. Mr. Larry Santana sends him off one more time. Brings him over, back body drop, and Butch Brooks falls hard. Donks to the back of the head. Larry Santana sends him off one more time. Sits him up, catches him in a big, no, it looked like a Bubba spike that time. Spine bust through. And three, it's over. And ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match is Larry Santana. Larry Santana not wanting to give it up this time. Still going at him, still putting the boots to Butch Brooks. Butch Brooks still getting the wrong end of Mr. Larry Santana. And Larry Santana still goes after Butch Brooks, the referee trying to get Larry Santana out of the ring. Larry Santana pitches Butch Brooks up and sends him out of the ring. And Mr. Larry Santana still hollering at Richie Dye. Ladies and gentlemen, back to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. A good match that time. Mr. Larry Santana, a very fine individual over Butch Brooks that time. And now in the ring at this time, at your table, I'm sorry, we have a rugged Richie Dye.
JC, I see your attitude's changed a little bit against us, but I got a few things I got to say, and it's starting with this Jimmy G. Lewis. Lewis? You went around, you squalled to the promoters. They gave you one last match. That's all I'm going to do. I'll beat you here to Kingdom Come. And Larry Santana, getting back here. Baby, we've had a long-running feud from here down in Georgia, Alabama, and everywhere we go. I'm telling you one thing, and I'm ready for it this time, Bobby. You holler for matches. You holler for matches. But, baby, I'm hollering for them, too, because I kicked your tail a long time ago, and I'm going to kick it again. So you can take it to the bank, and you can bank on it, baby, because when I get a hold of you, that's all it's wrote, baby, because it's me and you, and then when it's all over and said and done, I'm going to still be riding tall.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rugged Richie Dye, as he likes to call himself. He was real rugged, except when he come up on one crazy dog called Moondog Max. He said, I'm going to take the dog, I'm going to tear him apart, and I'm going to do to this. And it didn't work that way, ladies and gentlemen. I tell you what, that Moondog Max, he's one strange character, but let me tell you something. He don't say much, but he always gets the job done, and that's Moondog Max. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, in the ring one more time, here we have Mr. Rick Starr. And his opponent today, ladies and gentlemen, one of men's best friends, Moondog Max. This is a 10-minute time limit. Referee Bobby Abbott calls for the bell, and we're underway now. Mr. Rick Starr may be in for a big surprise because I tell you something, this dog gets hungry. This is a new dog. Rick Starr starts off by pulling the tights of the dog. The dog coming back in the ring don't like the tactics of Rick Starr pulling the tights. He's showing the referee that Rick Starr did pull the tights of the dog. Dog comes back in. I tell you what, he makes the dog mad. It's just like taking a bone away from a dog. Dog puts a forearm right across the back of Rick Starr. Puts a boot right up to the side of the head. Started off pulling the tights of the dog. You make the dog mad, he's just like a bulldog. He goes right after you. Goes off. The dog sends him off. Another elbow and Rick Starr goes down. He started off on the wrong foot with the dog. The dog comes in to wrestle. Rick Starr starts pulling tight. You know what I mean? There he goes. A fist to the midsection. Rick Starr, two fists. A fist to the top of the head. The dog comes up with his fist. Rick Starr's using the fist. The dog says, I'll use the fist. It's a forearm that time by Rick Starr. Uh-oh. The dog comes back at him this time. Yes. Okay. Yes, and I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, we have got a match coming up today that will be a main event anywhere, anytime you want to see this main event. We got the Uptown Rocker, Uptown, whatever you want to call him, Denny McCormick. He will be going up against one of the finest champions the Southeastern Championship Wrestling has ever seen, and that's in the Superstar. Superstar has a TV title match. I think that's the way it goes. A TV title match. Denny McCormick is finally, after the begging and pleading from the Superstar, give me a title match. Give me your title match. Superstars give the Uptown Rocker a title match. Now, the Uptown Rocker, Mr. Denny McCormick, is going to give the Superstar a title match. And let me tell you something, that is going to be one match that you don't want to miss. The dog, look here, in the ring. And while I'm sitting here taking care of business, talking about these fine wrestlers, such as the Superstar, the dog in the ring taking care of business. Rick Starr started off pulling the dog's tight, using the fist on the dog. And now Rick Starr trying to get away from the dog, and the dog's just staying right with him on that arm. Watch this. Uh-huh. The dog, he's got a different outlook. He's a changed dog. The dog has been turned loose from what I've heard. Still working on Rick Starr. I bet you Rick Starr's going to be sorry he got in the ring with the dog. Referee asked him if he gives. He ought to give it up because the dog can tear it off at any time, ladies and gentlemen. That's just the way it is. Like I say, I apologize one more time for my co-host, Mr. Tony Cargill, not being here. I don't know what the problem is. He comes and stands in for me a couple days, and then he finds out JC's back. He don't want to come back. I can't figure it out. Puts an elbow, and the dog comes out one time. Rick Starr Cut the dog down. I tell you what, you don't want to get this dog mad, Mr. Rickstar, because it's your grave if you do. Dog sent off. Oh, what happened that time? The referee gets in the way. What does the referee do that for? Referee gets in the way. The dog ought to hit the referee for getting in his way like that. I don't know. Referee goes out. The dog comes after it. Rickstar comes around and stops the dog. Look at the fist Rickstar has. Rickstar had no business into that. The referee gets in the dog's way. I don't understand that. There you go, Rickstar. So you was out there where you didn't belong. You come back into the ring. The dog's there waiting on you, son. Now you can go outside the ring. The dog will help you out. That's how I look at it. The referee comes out. Rickstar out. The dog standing alone inside the ring.
Get back. Get back in here. Oh!
Referee telling Mr. Rickstar to come back into the ring. He comes back in. The dog's still in there waiting on him. Dog puts a big paw right upside that head there that time. Another big clubbing forearm that time. Oh, reaches at him that time. Uses a fist, but of course I've seen Rickstar use the fist. Rickstar's going down. The dog's still after the referee. Dog still after Rickstar. One more time, puts a knee right upside the head of Rickstar. Rickstar down. The dog's still working on him. Referee calling for the break that time of the dog. Sends him into the corner and swings him off. Oh, big clubbing thrust. And I think that's what he calls the dog burying a bone. He buried the bone right in Rickstar that time. And Rickstar counts out. We got about 1 minute left in this match. And the dog's still standing tall over Rickstar. Comes up. The dog puts a foot right into the midsection. Forearm right across the back that time by the dog. Dog puts a fist upside the head that time. But the Rickstar has been using the fist himself. I have to look at it that way, ladies and gentlemen. The dog has learned some new words, I think. The superstar or whoever he's been hanging around with lately has learned him how to say shut up. Really, I do. Sends him off. Rickstar sent off. Dog catches him with a boot. Grabs him. Looks like he's setting him up for a pile driver possible. I don't know. Sets down, holds him. Dog's got him down. Got him for a count. One, two, and three. It's over. And ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match is a Moondog of Max. Man's best friend, I'll guarantee you right there. The dog never goes and says much, buddy, but when he goes to the ring, he gets the job done. The winner, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Moondog Max. Welcome back to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. With me right now, a very fine individual, very fine wrestler, Mr. Larry Santana. How you doing?
Hi, I appreciate it. How you doing? I want to come out here and say one thing. Won't you shut up and let me do what I do best, baby? Because that's what Mama and all the people in the Southeast have paid me to do. To come out here and run my pretty mouth. Because, baby, when you look at me, you're looking at the finest thing in professional wrestling. and there's only one guy that I want, and that's Richie Dye. He's been coming out here looking like Roy Rogers. But what do you want Mama say? Mama say him look like Dale Evans and got a breath odor of Trigger, because that's what we think about it. But come Nathan, baby, I'm going to get you one way or another. So thank you. Put it down in Southeastern history. Ladies and gentlemen, the man of the hour is going to be in your town. And when he comes, you play the bus, because, baby, I make the mega bus.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Larry Santana, very fine wrestler, very fine individual. He thinks a lot of his mother, and evidently his mama thinks a lot of him. And he's always there. He's looking for this, as he wants to call himself, the rugged Richie Dye. Richie Dye's going to have his hand full today with Jimmy G. Lewis. I don't know exactly what's happened there, but Jimmy G. Lewis is evidently rugged Richie Dye has opened his mouth one time too many. In the ring at this time, there is rugged Richie Dye, as he wants to call himself. And his opponent today, another very fine individual athlete, Mr. Jimmy G. Lewis. Jimmy G. Lewis, not waiting for Richie Dye. I guess this one's underway. The same way that rugged Richie Dye done Jimmy G. Lewis about 2 weeks ago. No love lost here, I guarantee you that. Jimmy G. Lewis not giving rugged Richie Dye an ounce of break there. Brings him over in a snap mare, starts putting a boost to that chest. Since rugged Richie Dye has turned on the dog, I'll guarantee you one thing. He has lost a lot of good friends, that is for sure, because he's finding out that this railroad track don't get any smoother on down there. There he goes, rugged Richie Dye. Puts a big clubbing forearm across the back. One more time. Got them fists taped up. I don't know for what reason, but he does for one reason. Puts that, slams that hit, but using the hair. Using the hair that time, rugged Richie Dye, using the hair. Comes off the second rope, stomps on that shoulder that time. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. Still working on that left arm, puts a knee right to us, bringing it the wrong way that time. Referee asking Jimmy G. Lewis, he wants to give it up. Rugged Richie Dye. I don't think, really, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think Jimmy G. Lewis would give it up like that. Goes in at him one more time. One more time, he goes in at him, and Jimmy G. Lewis laying down there. I don't know if rugged Richie Dye pulled a hair a while ago to come out of what he did. Hooking that arm. Jimmy G. Lewis, see, putting a boot to the head. Now, why did the man have to do that? Picks him up one time. Richie Dye swings him off the rope. Put a big drop kick that time. I've got to hand it to rugged Richie Dye. For a big man and as tall as he is, he does do a beautiful flying drop kick. I've got to hand that much to the man. I think either the superstar, the dog, or the genius, Lou Graham Jr., or the blonde bomber, may have showed him how to do that at one time in his life, and I don't know how it was. But somebody has evidently showed rugged Richie Dye something good. Rugged Richie Dye won't back up. Let the man in. See, here he comes again. Comes over. Referee puts him back one more time. Jimmy G. Lewis. See, here he comes. There he comes one more time. Now, see what I mean? There was no call for that. The man was trying to come back into the ring. Rugged Richie Dye didn't want him to come back into the ring. Had to throw the man back in the ring. But the forearm, I got to admit, that was a forearm that time from rugged Richie Dye. He got the man on the ropes. Referee calling for the break. Look at him. Grab a handful of hair. Everybody can see that. Hit him off. Put him up with a lariat that time. Very good move from rugged Richie Dye. They're choking the man. Right in the front of everybody out at TV 53 sees this. I'd like to also announce I want everybody to come down here next Saturday at 2 o'clock and join us here. It costs you nothing to get in. And we do have a special announcement I'd like to make while this match is going on, while rugged Richie Dye's pulling Jimmy G. Lewis up by the hair of the head. There's a benefit tonight for an 11-month-old baby that needs heart surgery. There's a benefit tonight at 7 o'clock at Cedar Hill Ball Field. That's East 48th Street in Chattanooga, Tennessee. This little girl is in very bad shape. She needs heart surgery. And this benefit is for her tonight to raise money for the expenses. That's it tonight at Cedar Hill Ball Field at at East 48th Street in Chattanooga, Tennessee. There's going to be gospel singing. It's going on today. It'll be fun and games, which is going on right now until 6 o'clock tonight. This is a benefit match tonight for 11-month-old Katie Hall that needs heart surgery at Cedar Hill Ball Field tonight in Chattanooga. So we invite everyone to come down there tonight. This is going for a good cause, ladies and gentlemen. I'll be honest with you, it is. It's going for an 11-month-old baby that needs heart surgery tonight at 7 o'clock. Rugged Richie Dye going right back to his tactics. Put the fist up the side of Jimmy G. Lewis's head. Got him right into the ropes. Brains him out. Still holding the hair. Puts a big kick right up into Jimmy G. Lewis's mouth. Jimmy G. Lewis goes out, comes out of the ring one time. Kicks him right in the mouth. Jimmy G. Lewis gets kicked in the mouth. Coming up. Rugged Richie Dye coming out. Comes out after the man. See? Comes right out after the man. And still after the man. Jimmy G. Lewis coming back into the ropes. Rugged Richie Dye right in behind him. Don't know exactly what's going on here, but there he goes. Kicking the man upside the head. And Jimmy G. Lewis. Jimmy G. Lewis. Coming outside the ropes. Jimmy G. Lewis coming outside the ring one more time, going back towards the dressing room. Rugged Richie Dye still standing in the middle of the ring. Referee putting the count on, and he calls for the bell. The winner is Rugged Richie Dye. Don't know exactly how that turned out, but Jimmy G. Lewis just decided that he wants to leave, and he left the ring. But like I was saying a while ago, ladies and gentlemen, we did have... Southeastern Championship Wrestling. Now, I have the privilege that makes my hour. Let me tell you something. I've got a very fine individual with me and a surprise. We haven't seen this young lady in a while. You're all the time full of surprises, aren't you, Superstar?
That's what impresses you about me, isn't it, JC?
I got to admit, you are one slick character.
I'm telling you, and Denny McCormick, Uptown Rocker, he's fixing to find out how impressive I really am. I guess you done told these dumb hillbillies out here what's fixing to happen to Denny McCormick today. She's going to be carrying two belts around.
Yeah,
get a one.
Now, I got to admit, when I first come to Southeastern Championship Wrestling, you said you was going to get that belt. You did. And the Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, just might ought to watch out today.
Well, you know, I got tired of the TV title. The only reason Denny McCormick has it today.
Yes, I can understand that.
I just noticed that she has two hands and she can carry two belts instead of one.
Yes, I understand.
And that's more money in my pocket.
I see a very good friend of mine and yours both coming up here now.
At Moondog.
Yeah.
You know, we're sending him to obedience school.
Yes, I noticed he's learning some new tricks here.
We're teaching him to talk, and we're teaching him to walk, and we're teaching him to destroy.
Destroy, yep.
That's the main thing, is destroy.
Right here. I noticed he has come up with a few new words.
Well, you know, when he runs around with a superstar, you know, you got to have that extra class. You can't just be a dog.
This is true.
You got to be a show dog, too.
That's true.
He's got the killer instinct. He's always had the killer instinct. And with our tutelage, you know where he's going to go, don't you?
Right.
Straight to the top.
That's right.
So each week, you'll see more and more of the dog, and you might even see him one of these days come here in a tuxedo.
A dog with clothes on. I got to see this. Very fine dog.
You tell all these people out here just don't walk away from that television, because they're going to see Denny McCormick destroyed right here on TV. That's what I've been wanting to do.
Cut.
The whole time. Denny McCormick's been here. I'm going to put him out once and for all.
Cut. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Moondog Max, the superstar, and a big surprise. This young lady has been out for a while, Miss Baby Doll. It's good to see her back. That kind of makes my day. You get a good-looking woman like that to come out here and stand beside me. I'm telling you, it just makes my day. Superstar. I tell you what, following this man around, been watching him, and the man's got style. I got to admit this. The man does have style. We have some new people coming in here today. We got one guy, I don't know, this guy, it's really... I just hadn't figured him out yet. Ladies and gentlemen, in the ring at this time, on your screen, you do see Chief Little Lynn. And his opponent is Chief Little Lynn. And his opponent is the Shadow. We've seen him a couple of times here. This man is coming a long ways. Comes out here, and we're going for the bell. Here we go. Referee Bobby Abbott calls for the bell. Chief Little Lynn comes in, starts in. Arm drag takedown. Another one he goes that time. Little Lynn's fast, little guy, let me tell you his. But I tell you what, and a drop kick, and the Shadow comes out. Chief Little Lynn, there he goes, you know, pulling the man's fights. The man comes out. Shadow calls for timeout. Referee Bobby Abbott trying to put Chief Little Lynn back over where he belongs there. Referee says, I'll get him in. People outside, Chief Little Lynn pulling the tights of the Shadow that time. Shadow puts his hand up, wants to test some strength here with Chief Little Lynn. Everybody is hollering, hell, you better watch out, Chief. I'll tell you what, they lock up one hand. Here they go one more time. Shadow puts Chief down. Got some fans here coming up behind the Chief. Now watch him. There you go, the Shadow. I told you, a very smart individual this time. Very smart. Brains him and throws him out. Chief Little Lynn falls out. Look at him. Starts picking at the dog. He picks at the dog very long. I tell you what. See, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. There you go. See, you don't come in here and start stuff like that with a dog. The dog has you. You'll know it. Right, like he may be sending for a pile driver right outside. I just kind of knocked that horse. I think that's what the superstar calls crush. Yeah, that's it. That's how a dog crushes a bone right there. I know Little Lynn shouldn't have come out there and started something with a dog. Really, ladies and gentlemen, I do. I call it the way I see it anymore. Chief Little Lynn comes out there trying to pick at the dog. You don't pick at a dog. I'm telling you, you know. These boys are going to learn. These men are going to learn when you come into Southeastern Championship Wrestling. You start fooling around with the dog. There he goes one more time. Chief Little Lynn pulling the mask of the Shadow. And Little Lynn fighting it back at the dog. Hell. And the dog still working on him outside the ropes. I'm telling you what. The dog picks up something, looks like a can, hits him with it. Trying to get Little Lynn back into the ring. Little Lynn wants out there with the dog more than he wants in the ring with the Shadow. I don't know what his problem is. Comes off. Puts an elbow down across the chest of Shadow. Backs him in. Sends him off. Got him in a sleeper, it looks like. Looks like Little Lynn has the Shadow into a sleeper. Looks like he's going into the sleeper. He may be choking the man, is what I think it is. I can't honestly say. The dog seen it. I know the dog sees the choke, and he come up on the side of the ring. Looks like the Chief went in for it, goes up on the second rope. Going up on the top when it comes off and dives off on the Shadow. And the dog seen the fist that time from Chief Little Lynn. Yes, he did. Pops him right in the throat. See there? illegal karate chop right there from the chief. Comes in, goes in, looks like he's setting him up for a three or four. Got him down, putting the pressure on. There he is. He's locked it in on the shadow. Asking the shadow if he wants to give. The referee asking if he wants to give. Looks like the dog sees something going on. I'm not too sure what it is. The shadow makes it to the rope that time. Referee not seeing it. Dog's just like any other good guard dog. He sees something illegal going on, he'll be there to make sure the referee is brought to the referee's attention. Dog's just in the mask where Chief Little M been trying to get into the mask there. See, now that's what I can't understand about this new guy coming in here. Chief Little M comes into Southeastern Championship Wrestling, goes after the man's mask. Now, what does he want to do that for? The man wears a mask because he don't want these rednecks or these people, as he says, to know who he is. Slings him off one time. The shadow's got it going his way. A big back drop that time, and Little Lynn goes down. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you about this match coming up between the superstar and Denny McCormick one more time. This is going to be a good one. Another one, though. Chief down. Shadow drops a big knee right across the top of the forehead that time. But this match coming up, I tell you what, with the uptown rocker, he calls himself, Denny McCormick against the superstar. Superstar said, oh, the chief pulled the tights that time. It looked like the shadow brought him over in a snap suplex. The shadow had him set up. Chief puts him up. Look at that. Has that mask. Watch him. See, gets the referee's attention. What did he do? Put a fist to the man's top of the man's head. Why? Why did he do that? Why did he have to go to those tactics? Shadow looks like he may be in just a little bit of trouble. The Chief Little M goes up, goes to the second ring rope, cuts it off. Uh-huh. And you could hear the dog outside barking to tell him to move. I'll guarantee you did. Dog, I tell you, he's learning some new tricks and learning some new language. I tell you, this superstar has taken over, and they're working on this man. Monkey Flip comes out, Shadow gets him. He comes out, Little M laying down right in the middle of the ring. Brings him up and drapes his head down across the rope. He's out there trying to get a hold of the dog one more time. Little Lynn trying to fight both men. Little Lynn fighting both men outside the ring there. The dog trying to get Little Lynn off of him. Finally, the dog breaks loose and hits him there one time. So still trying to get Little Lynn off of him. Little Lynn slapping him, trying to hit him. Little Lynn still trying to fight the dog outside the ring. Little Lynn, there he goes. The dog knocks him loose, finally. The dog knocks him loose that time. I got to admit, the dog did knock him loose that time. Little Lynn inside the ring fighting the shadow, and then comes out and tries to fight the dog. Don't know what his problem is. He needs to take care of what he's got going inside the ring. Puts a big elbow right there in the top of the chief's head. The chief's down. Got some fine camera work, ladies and gentlemen, from this Channel 53 here. Everybody's invited every Saturday at 2 o'clock. Come down here and be with us. Everybody's invited. Anytime you see Southeastern Championship Wrestling, you know that there's some fine, fine athletes. I'll guarantee you. Little Ann kicks off at the count of two this time. Shadow comes over, picks him up by the arm. Want everybody to see that. Picks him up. And Little Lynn puts him in the rope, slings him off. Puts him in, goes in, looks for the sleeper one more time. It might be that chokehold again. The dog comes up on the side of the ring. Dog comes into the ring, sees a chokehold going on. Dog sees a chokehold going on. Referee says for the dog to get out. Dog won't get out. Referee calls for the bell. Move Dog Max comes in, sees the Little Lynn choking this shadow. That's the second time that it's happened. And I'm going to tell you something. Little Lynn's going to pay for this one. Choking the shadow. He's been picking on the dog. The referee goes down. Now I may have to get some help out here for this referee. It gets in the way. I'm telling you what. I'll ring the bell. Get some help out here for the referee. We'll get some help out here for the referee. Referee's back up again. Shadow goes up on the second ring rope. There he comes off. Puts one right to Little Lynn. Little Lynn was choking the shadows, kind of made him mad, picking on the dog outside. Referee's going back to the dressing room, going to have to get somebody out of here to help this Chief Little Lynn's newcomer. It's a kind of a rude awakening to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. get him rung up here to get some help out here. We can get some out here for him. Oh, I should have known it. Here he comes. Sticking his nose where nobody needed to be. The uptown rocker, Denny McCormick. And ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match is, by disqualification, is the Chief Little End. Uptown rocker Denny McCormick standing, sitting in a ring over Chief Little End. Welcome one more time back to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. And with me right now, three very fine individuals. The genius, Luke Graham Jr., the blonde bomber, Mahler Mays, Killer Kyle. How you guys doing today? I'm glad to have you here.
JC, you know it's good to be here today. And if all you rednecks would shut up a minute and let me talk. You know, my assassin, he's going to be out for a week or two here. I've got the genius, crazy Luke, and the blonde bomber here with me. Hey. You got this tag team that's come in here, the Midnight Riders. Hey, the Killer Kyle is here. He's here to stay. We got rid of the pizza makers, the Italian rockers, or what you call them. You know, the Killer Kyle got rid of them. Hey, I got rid of Ebony here last week. He ain't going to be back no more. The pizza makers ain't going to be back. And the Midnight Riders, they want to come out here and brag about they're here to whoop anybody, take on any contract and all that. Hey, all they got to do is crawl in the ring with the Killer Kyle once. And I'll get me a partner. And hey, they'll be going back. They'll be down here on the street corner bumming money to get back to Alabama. They ain't going to take no belts or nothing back. Tell them about it, Blanc.
Yeah, Killer Kyle, these Italian rockers don't want no part of it. I understand they're so embarrassed because they got grape stains on the bottom of their feet. Well, let me tell you people something. There's a lot going on at Southeastern Championship now, baby. Now, come to tonight, we'll be in Roswell, Georgia. And any of you people can afford it to come watch the greatest, you be there. The 22nd, we'll be in Athens, Tennessee. Now, I understand, I don't know who we got in Athens, but apparently the Florida boys, Pat Armstrong, Kevin Catlin, apparently they done chickened out on us, Luke. Apparently they're going to send somebody to take their place. They're too scared to come back up here the 22nd. That's who it is, the 22nd, that's right. Anyway, I understand these two masked guys from Florida are supposed to be coming up taking their place. Well, let me tell you something, Floridians. You better go back and get your gator breath out of our business because this same thing's going to happen to you that happened to Florida boys when they come in a ring with Luke Graham and myself.
Okay, it's glad to have you boys here.
Let me ask you something here. Me and Mahler Mays have took this championship, tag team championship, three times.
That's right, man.
And they've held it up.
That's right.
Now, if they have done chickened out and ain't coming back, why ain't the bell
there?
That's what I can't understand.
I'm going to check into that. I promise you, I'll check into that. Right now, we got what they call the Midnight Riders in the ring.
Hey, don't forget to tell all these rednecks to look for the Midnight Riders down here on the corner when they leave because they're going to be taking donations to get back to Alabama.
Okay, I got to do that. Word from Killer Kyle. Ladies and gentlemen, the people at Killer Kyle's, the genius Luke Graham Jr. and Blonde Bomber has been talking about is the guys in the ring right now from Huntsville, Alabama, the Midnight Riders. Ladies and gentlemen, their opponent is another fine athlete, is Killer Kyle and the Spoiler. this a spoiler is. I haven't seen this guy in action. I'm not sure. But I tell you what, these Alabama boys better find out they're no longer in Alabama. They're at Southeastern Championship Wrestling now. Killer Kyle, he don't cut nobody no slack, and I'm sure that Killer Kyle has the spoiler. If the spoiler is a friend of Killer Kyle's, then the spoiler is one bad individual himself. And ring a bell. Here we go. This is about a 10-minute time limit. I'll tell you what, and the spoiler starts out. I don't know who this is. I don't know if this is Mike Mason or Randy Rogers. It's one of them. He goes in. The spoiler goes in after him. The Midnight Rider ducks out of the way. The spoiler still looking at him. Spoiler comes at him one more time. Alabama boy must be scared of this spoiler. He keeps running from him. I can see that already. Still want to mention about the benefit tonight for 11th spoiler. Look at that. Just pushes him right off. I still want to mention that benefit tonight for 11-month-old Katie Hall. It's at Cedar Hill Ball Field tonight in Chattanooga at East 48th Street in Chattanooga. This little girl's 11 months old. She does need heart surgery. This benefit is for her to help the transportation for this heart surgery. There is a gospel singing going on right now there today, and they're having fun and games and stuff like that going on right now until 6 o'clock tonight. Evidently, this Midnight Rider pulling the mask of the spoiler. Killer Kyle seen it. Killer Kyle seen it. Midnight Riders, evidently they're after the belts. They cheat and get them any way they can. Look at here. Backed him up one time. The Alabama boy, the Midnight Rider, backed him up. I don't know if this is Mike Mason, but look here. The man comes in, no tag made. I didn't see no tag. I didn't see no tag that time. No, I didn't. Well, referee Bobby Abbott puts him out. That's the way it should be. I got to admit, got to hand it to the referee there, ladies and gentlemen. I really do. Referee puts them out. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to plug this match one more time. We got a match coming up for the television title, the TV title match between them. A great athlete and a superstar going up against the Uptown Rocker, Danny McCormick. And another surprise from the superstar, ladies and gentlemen, Baby Doll's back. Baby Doll got the Southeastern Heavyweight Championship belt. Now she wants the TV title match. Sends him off. There he comes. See, double teaming by the Midnight Riders. Now, if that's the way they're trying to win belts by double teaming, now trying to go after the man's match. Trying to go after the man. Look, see, here comes one around the ring like this. The referee putting the Midnight Rider back in. Putting it back in. Tag was made that time. Killer Kyle comes in. Tag was made that time by Killer Kyle and the spoiler. Now I guarantee you the Midnight Riders. Look here. Killer Kyle smacks the man. You see him chop him across the chest that time? Killer Kyle backs the man in. He's going to pay for what he... We got about 2 minutes left in this match. Now the Midnight Rider. I guarantee you whatever they rode in on, it's going to be hard for him to ride out on, because that would jar your spine right there. Picked him up. Looks like he set him for a spine buster that time, a version of a suplex that time. Now the big man comes in. Drops his elbow down across him. Got about 2 minutes left in this match, ladies and gentlemen. Got about 2 minutes left. Puts a big forearm right upside. I don't know if this is Mike Mason or Randy Rogers. Oh. Fuller going in after one of the Midnight Riders. The tag was made that time. Killer Kyle comes back in. Fuller holding, puts a boot right into the midsection. Kyle picks him up one more time. Looks like he may have put a thumb to the throat, but I'm not sure. I couldn't be honest. I don't think Killer Kyle would go to that kind of tactics, ladies and gentlemen. I really don't. Picked him up one more time. We got 1 minute remaining in this match. We got about 1 minute remaining. But this next match coming up, ladies and gentlemen, I'm telling you, this next match is going to be a real good one. Killer Kyle has him in a front chancery this time. Got about 30 seconds left in this match. Alabama, Midnight Rider tries to come in the rope. Send him off. Double elbow that time coming off by Killer Kyle in the spoiler. Tag was made. This match got about 15 seconds left in this match. Big Fuller comes up. Put him a hammer there. Down this time. Goes in. 3, 2, 1. This match is over. Ladies and gentlemen, back to Southeastern Championship Wrestling. One more time, I have a fine crowd here today. With me right now, as everybody can see, the Uptown Rocker, Mr. Denny McCormick.
As always, it's your pleasure, JC. As far as me having to beg anybody for anything, sure, I've had to beg the superstar for a title shot. There's one thing you got to get straight. He's getting his title shot right here on TV today. And all he's got to do is come out here and put it on the line, because that's what I'm doing, baby.
Okay, word from the Uptown Rocker, the possibly the former TV 53 heavyweight champion. His opponent today is the superstar, and I'll tell you something. Superstar is always full of surprises. When he comes to the arena, he drives in style. He runs around with valets. I mean, he's all the time got somebody different there. The lifestyle, you just wouldn't believe. And I hear some music. Gentlemen, this is the music of the Uptown Rocker, Mr. Denny McCormick. You see him in the ring today. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're waiting for his opponent. This is a TV 53 title match. Did you hear the music? Southeastern heavyweight champion. It is the superstar with a very nice surprise. Miss Baby Doll is back. This is the TV 53 television title match. This is a television time remaining. Nice to see this Baby Doll. I tell you what, superstar always has a fine valley, a very fine individual. This is the TV 53 television title match. Very fine individual. Right. Big part of tonight, I have just been invited to by the superstar.
Oh, the rest of them be another party tonight.
Be a party tonight as a superstar, because he will have this TV 53 television title match. This is television time remaining. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to announce this one more time. We're going to be in Athens, Tennessee, the 22nd of this month. That's Athens, Tennessee, at the National Guard Armory. Tonight, They're going to be there at the Cedar Hill Ball Field in Chattanooga for the benefit match for the 11-month-old baby girl that's needing heart surgery. So everyone can be out there tonight at Cedar Hill Ball Field tonight. This benefit's going for Miss Katie Hall, 11-month-old baby that needs heart surgery. That's at 7 o'clock tonight. So everyone come on out there tonight, please. Superstar helping Miss Baby Doll outside the ring. Referee checking over the superstar. Superstar checking out here. Referee looking at him here. This is a television time remaining. Referee Bobby Abbott. Maybe call it for the bell. Here we go. This is television time remaining. And I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, just now handed to me, I have the Southeastern Heavyweight Championship belt, and I have the TV 53 Heavyweight Championship match. We're going to rock, watch this match very closely here. Miss Baby Doll outside the ring watching over the superstar. The Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, the superstar, rocks up one time. There it goes, Denny McCormick right after the mask, the first thing.
Get back
there
off his mask,
man. And the referee, Bobby Abbott, telling the Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, stay off the mask.
Stay off the mask.
One more time. Lock up, collar and elbow. They start back one more time. Drag takedown next time. Denny McCormick may have went to the tights that time as a superstar. Referee Bobby Abbott cautioning the man about staying out of the superstar's sights. It's the same way the match started off the last time we were here. The Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, pulls the mask and goes for the tights. Referee cautioning the Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, about to fist. There he goes. Arm drag takedown one more time. Superstar comes out of the ring. Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick, going back to the tights one more time. Referee Bobby Abbott, there's a picture of the superstar and a very fine looking young lady, Miss Baby Doll.
Don't do it no more, boy.
Well, there goes a superstar. Ladies and gentlemen, we got television time remaining on this, but if some chance this match does decide to go that far, we will show you the conclusion of this match next week. Next week, we will show you the conclusion of this match. So we're going to keep the cameras rolling. A big backdrop that time by the Uptown Rocker, Danny McCormick, goes down for an arm drag takedown. We don't have about 15 seconds remaining, but we will show you the conclusion of this match next Saturday. At 2 o'clock, we will show the conclusion of this match. So we're going to keep the cameras rolling, ladies and gentlemen. Lock up one more time. The strength of the superstar just kind of breaking that hold just goes right over. Superstar picked him up. Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick. Ladies and gentlemen, still going after it. And the Uptown Rocker, Denny McCormick.